Howdy folks! So today I'm going to be redesigning one of my main characters. I call them my main characters. I have four of them. This is Harley. He is the boyfriend to my other character, Isaac. So I was doing an exercise where I was kind of turning him into a different kind of species. And I realized that, like, taking away some of his features and adding new ones, like, it just wasn't working for me. Like, it wasn't coming out the way that I wanted it to. Like, he lacked a lot of interest. So today, I'm going to be going through and trying to come up with a design that I like a lot better, because I've been also going through and updating the reference sheets of my other characters. And I just don't like how this looks right now. I think that this is not good. It's not that the design itself is bad, it's just, like, looking at it, it's, like, not what I want it to be. So, this is something I did in my sketchbook. You can see my laptop stickers in the background there. And this is just kind of a little bit of brainstorming that I did. I'm gonna show you kind of the things that I changed. First of all, I'm gonna do the crisscrosses on the shaved half, because I like doing that. I'm gonna add a band-aid over his nose, because he's supposed to be, like, a jock, and, like, supposed to be, like, really athletic. I want to add in a tie somewhere to Isaac, his boyfriend, because Isaac has this little pink ring, which is going to be the color of his jersey, Harley's jersey, now, and Harley has nothing that ties him to Isaac, and also these are not, like, good sneakers, so I'm gonna change them to, like, Nike sneakers or something, and of course a little, Letterman jacket, and I'm gonna be changing the shape of his eyes, cause, that's something I usually do. Like, the main thing that differentiates my characters is the eye shape, and I want his to be more square and rounded off, and just some, like, random stuff, like, what can I do to attach him to Isaac, different kinds of earring ideas, cause he has a lot of piercings, or he's supposed to have a lot of piercings. At the moment, he's only got no earrings over here, but he's got an earring. He's supposed to have an earring here, and he has a tongue piercing, too. So, yeah, and also, you can barely see the one, so I'm gonna change that. And those are just some kind of things that I want to go for when I go for the first pass at this redesign. And I've got the little sensor bar over his, for his chest, even though he's a dude, it's fine. So the way that I kind of want to go about this is the original design, so I still have a grasp of what he is used to looking like. The first concept, which is kind of taking aspects from here and translating them properly. And then I'm also going to take the two kind of aspects of his personality visually and put them together, which is like a jock and then a very flirty playboy type character. And then just kind of combine my favorite aspects from these two here. Wow, we can barely see that. Let me get a different color. So you can get the aspects of these guys and from this guy. And probably very minimal from the original. Probably just like some color palette stuff. To create a little brand spanking new Harley Drake. So yeah, I'm gonna go for the first pass at this, which is just redrawing the original Harley. Which is this guy. So yeah, let's do that real quick. Oh, by the way, this is a base by Star Stickers on DeviantArt. I use it for everything. Commissions, I use it for personal characters, everything. So I really recommend you guys go check it out. The link will be in the description. But yeah, let's get to sketching. Okay, so this is Harley's original design, kind of. This is, like, what he is looking like at this very moment in time. As you can see, doesn't look great. Oh, I forgot the little number one on the front of it. I'm gonna have to look up what an actual jersey looks like, because I guarantee you that's not it. But yeah, that's the original current design. So now, I'm going to take the second pass at his design, which is taking stuff from the concept that I created in my sketchbook. So yeah, let's go for that real quick and do some quick sketching. Now, looking at like the first pass of the new design, I'm already like loving it so much more than I liked the other one. I don't know what it is. I think it's probably like the more, I think it's the band-aid, honestly. And probably the jersey. As you can see, I put little question marks on both this little eye necklace, because if you look at Isaac's sheet, he has a little eye in a shirt. And also a little question mark next to the ring, because like I said, Isaac's ring is going to be the new color of, Harley's jersey. But other than that, I think that, like, adding in the earrings and the little band-aid, and even just doing something as simple as, making the hair a lot straighter, kind of just made me love the design even more than I even expected that I would. And I think that's what most important is that he still looks vaguely like this, like pretty much like the same character, you know? It's not such a drastic difference that it doesn't even look like the same character. And I think if I put down colors, it would be even more evident that, hey, this is still Harley. This isn't like some new kind of completely different person. This is still Harley, just like with a new coat of paint. So that's kind of, I'm already really liking this, where this is going. So the next kind of stage that I want to go for is, the two things that I kind of wanted Harley to be when I first created him. So I created him specifically to be Isaac's boyfriend, because I just wanted to give Isaac a boyfriend for the heck of it, because that's, like, the only reason I really created him. He wasn't even intended to be as fleshed out as he is now. And the two things that I wanted him to be is, number one, a jock. I wanted him to be, like, captain of every sports team in every season. And I also wanted him to be super flirty like a playboy. And that was also kind of like, I wanted him to be everything that Isaac wasn't. Isaac is very shy and he's very much a nerd and he's a hopeless romantic. Harley is the confident type. He knows what he wants. He knows how to get it. So, this kind of, the jock area is kind of where I get stuff like the band-aid. Let me make a new layer here so I don't screw up my sketches. The jock is blue. That's where, like, the band-aid comes from. It's where the jersey comes from. These sneakers, the shorts. Whereas the other aspect, which is, like, the super flirty type, which I'm gonna put in green, is where the, all these earrings and bedazzlements come from. It's also partially where this jewelry is gonna be coming from, and the really fancy hair, and his hair is dyed purple at the tip, so I'm even gonna, like that, like, and you can see, like, there are parts of him that are from both kind of aspects of his personality. So, and I like to represent my character's personality through their design, because I'm not a writer and I don't write stories, I tell stories through my art, so if I can't play with symbolism and that kind of thing, I don't know what I would do. So, on that note, we're gonna start with the jock. We're gonna start over here. And yeah, I'm gonna start getting to sketching. So for the jock, this is what I came up with. You're gonna notice that, yes, I absolutely did just copy and paste the shoes directly from the concept. That's because I hate drawing shoes, and they came out exactly how I wanted them to. Don't hate me. So I gave him the varsity jacket. I carried over the band-aid, like I said, because that's like something that really fits the bill for something that I love about the character. As soon as I drew it on him, I knew that that's what I loved. And I gave him a little varsity jacket with, like I said, with the little pins on it. And of course, I'm going to flesh those out. They're not just going to be little circles. And I don't know what color. I think I'm going to put it as a cooler color, because even though he looks like a jock, he's supposed to be a very friendly character. He's supposed to be a very friendly, energetic character. So I'm thinking blue and maybe some of the pink thrown in there as well, because pink is his color. He likes pink and purple, so definitely gonna add in some purples and stuff in there as well. So that's a nice cool color. I did get rid of his earrings, because like if he's playing like basketball or football, you don't want like these big old chains hanging down. If I were to completely go with this design though, I probably would like be like, oh, let's just give him like a couple of ball earrings and like a little, you know, like that. But I wouldn't want anything dangling, because it'd be very difficult, and you don't want anything getting caught when you're trying to play your sport ball, you know. So that's the first pass of the jock. I'm gonna move over to the Playboy and kind of see what I can do with this one. So let's get to sketching. Okay, so this is what I came up with. Now, obviously, Harley is a high school student. He wouldn't show up to school every day wearing this. But it's just kind of to give me an idea of what it might look like. Again, I did literally copy and paste the earrings over. And I don't even think I grafted them on correctly, but that's fine. But just because I liked how they looked and they were perfect. So I was like, oh, that's great. something that I forgot to mention about the jock version is that his hair is a lot shorter, for the same kind of reasons why I didn't give him big dangly earrings, because it would get in the way. However, for this one, I made it a lot longer and flowier, because I feel like if he's going to be looking all fancy and dapper, he wants it to be like all nice and flowy. He can do stuff with it, maybe even do like a longer gradient because of it, different colors, that kind of thing. And of course, I had to give him the aviator shades. And dress shoes. Those are my attempt at dress shoes. Don't they look great? Let me fix that. But yeah, so taking into account all these three designs that I've made right here, I'm going to make a final design and kind of take aspects from each of the designs that I really, really like, including the original design, by the way, and just sort of try and create a design that I'll be happy with in the end, because that's the goal. I really want to make Harley into something that I love. So yeah, let's go for it. Let's just get to sketching real quick and see what we can come up with here. Okay, so the first thing that I did before I sort of went ahead and started the design process was make a reference for my references. I just sort of put every single design that I had made to this video over here, the original design here and just my sketches really little in the corner, just so I could have a little bit of reference to go off of. And this is what I came up with. So you'll notice a lot of it comes from the jock and the first concept, and that's because I really, really loved the way that they were going. However, I did keep the aviator shades, and the necklace actually is what I decided on for the tie. And this is going to be dress pants. The pants are going to be like dressy black pants or something like that. And I actually gave him fingerless gloves, which is something I didn't even believe. I can't even believe I didn't think of that when I was originally making him. And those are not from any particular design, actually. Those are something that I originally thought of. Actually, boop, in this outfit right here, Harley has fingerless gloves that are actually a very similar style. Except this bit here, right here, is, oh crap, what did I, okay, I did it on the wrong layer. Is going to be filled in with color instead of it just being windowed to his hand. So yeah, that's what I came up with. I'm actually really happy with this. So what now? Well, what now is we get to start doing color mock-ups. So I'm gonna make a sheet for that and I'll be right back. Okay, so this is what I came up with for a little sheet. I also cleaned up the sketch so not any things are less overlappy, and that kind of thing. Oh, I forgot to erase the whole belly button. Your belly button does not show through your shirt. I don't know if you guys knew that. It's a little known fact. Anyways. So I'm gonna be limiting myself to 4 palettes. This is what I usually do for most things. Usually it's 3. The reason I'm doing 4 this time is because I'm going to call them a little bit of each of a different thing. So this one right here is going to be basing pretty much all of it on the original design. This one is going to be stepping away from it. This one is going to be what I think that after doing 2 mock-ups, what I really want. And this one is going to be the crazy one. I always do one where I just let myself go absolutely ham and have no theme in particular. So yeah, I'm going to do all 4 of these and kind of just come back in and sort of talk about each of them. Oh, and if you were ever wondering how I color my stuff in, this is how I do it. I outline everything, I color everything in gray, I put a clipping layer over the top, and then I can just do like that. And wow, look at that, it never goes outside the lines. It's almost as if by magic. Anyways, let's begin. Thank you. here are the four color palettes that I come up with. So the first one, as you can see, is based... Let me get my red marker out again, as in this. this one right here is based around the original color palette. That's not it, but... This one is kind of a progression. It's building off of it. It's kind of just like a place for me to go a little crazier, but not as crazy as you'll see. And then this third one is just kind of building off of what I got from these two other ones. You'll see like the... I'll show you sort of what comes through from each of them. So this will be red, and this will be the dark blue. So the hair color is definitely staying the same. That's going to stay the same. And this one you see I tried a little bit of a darker color, but I kept it lighter. The outside color of the band-aid came from that one, but the inside color of the band-aid came from the other one. Over here, I kept the color of the shaved part of his head the same, as well as the earring colors here. However, for the smaller earring, it was this color, this from there. So then, the sneakers, are pretty similar. I'm gonna circle them from that, but I actually inverted the color palette. I'm pretty sure these pants stayed the same color throughout, but however, the red came through, because I still want him to have some red in there, because he is a pretty active and energetic character who can be a little angry sometimes. it's a pretty small thing, but the color came through. And then, I think these are... Oh, these are actually different. Okay, so the pants actually came from the... second one. The eye color progressively got darker, so it doesn't really come from anywhere in particular. However, the shade color does come from the red one mostly, as well as the jacket color and the color of these pins here. And then we come to the fourth one, which I have not spoken about at all because I'm not using it. It was just kind of like a little playground for me, like it's a what if type thing. you can see I didn't even bother finishing coloring in these three pins. You might have noticed that I did a purple-blue-pink gradient, and I decided to change it to pink-purple because it looked too much like the bisexual flag, and Harley's not bi, so. Oh, and I also made the dress pants pitch black, just for the heck of it, why not? But if you can't tell, this one in this third one right here is the winner. Let's do a little... celebratory lines, am I right, boys and girls? This is the one we're doing. So, what now? I'm just gonna take this sketch, I'm gonna clean it up, and I'll come back to you guys, and we'll do like a side-by-side comparison. Okay, y'all, I finished cleaning it up. I made some very minor color edits here and there, but it's pretty much the same design. So I'm so excited to finally share Harley's completed redesign in 3, 2... Bam! There he is. I think that my favorite part about this redesign is that it still looks like him. Pretty much everything color-wise on his body itself is the same. The jersey is still there. The white of the shoes. Like, everything is sort of still there. But it's just a lot cleaner, and it's a lot more cohesive, and it actually looks kind of how I wish I could have designed him, you know, when I first created him. So, I'm so happy with this, y'all. It's so cool. I'm so happy. Once again, the base that I used for pretty much the entire process will be linked in the description below. Make sure to go give the base maker some love. But yeah, I'm so happy. Thank you guys for sort of following me through this process. Peace. I didn't smoke no grass today, but that's 'cause I'm the one on stage. So who am I to take away what makes you feel different?